relatively fresh off Scorpion's Revenge and hella fresh off Aftermath, both of which were awesome. I'd like to go over another Mortal Kombat topic before I delve into some more boring topics focused on my visual novels and upcoming books. Shit people don't care about as much. But the greater wide world loves Mortal Kombat, and I am among them. I love this franchise more and more every day. But while I was watching Scorpion's Revenge in particular, I got to thinking, man, there's some shady, dirty motherfuckers in Mortal Kombat. But who is the shadiest, dirtiest of all? Point blank, who is the most evil character in the Mortal Kombat universe? Now, obviously, we got a lot of people to choose from, but I like to stick with four. After all, four is the way we break down the greats. You got Mount Rushmore, you got the Fantastic Four, and you got the Four Horsemen. So in this video, we'll be discussing the four most evil characters in Mortal Kombat, breaking them down from four all the way to one. One being the evilest, dirtiest son of a bitch of the bunch. But first, I'd like to go over some honorable mentions. I think we can all agree that Kano is one no good son of a bitch. He gives off this creepy vibe that leaves you wondering just how many bitches does this nigga have chained in his basement? We're all familiar with his exploits as the ringleader of the Black Dragon. You know they always up to some shady shit. Dealing with Shang Tsung, Shao Kahn, and the like. And I can tell they're not too particularly fond of this motherfucker either, but bad guys partner up every now and then. And so they get to not trusting each other, and we know how that shit goes. Kano, most infamous for his ongoing rivalry with Sonya Blade and Jax. It's a lot of fucking shit that's not necessarily explained thoroughly. Like, we know that Kano killed Sonya's partner, but we don't necessarily know the full details or the full extent of why she hates Kano so much. If you were to fill in the blanks, you have to wonder, like, was there something deeper going on between these two? Did he hit that pussy? Did he break her heart? I don't know, because she hates this motherfucker pretty intently. But Kano, he's a dirty motherfucker, man. You can't trust him. He'll stab you in the back at the drop of your hat. And while he is pretty shady, I just don't know how evil he is, man. Like, I think there may be some good somewhere in Kano. Even though he may be technically evil, I don't think he's the definition of evil like some of the people who made this list. So Kano, definitely deserving of an honorable mention. Our second honorable mention is Melina. Everybody loves Melina. She's hot to death. Now, whether you want to go with the original fucking storyline or the new storyline, the original, her being Katana's sister from birth, pretty much. They were like twins, I reckon. That was the thing they were going with. Or the second timeline where Melina was created in Shang Tsung's flesh pits. Melina had it pretty rough, man, and she's psychologically scorned from the fact that she's got this Tarkatan blood, and it fucks up her appearance to the point where she has to keep her fucking grill covered because she got them fucking Tarkatan fangs going on, and she's also got the Tarkatan bloodlust going on, so she's not necessarily the most stable bitch out here. Melina, she got a lot of fucking dirt under her nails, a lot of blood on her fangs. She's fucked up shit out here. And we know she has a deep-seated hatred and jealousy of her sister slash half-sister, whatever you want to call her, Katana. And while she has committed some very dirty deeds, especially if you read the Mortal Kombat X comic books, you know, she's not the most fucking angelic of characters. And her attempt to hold on to the Outworld crown as the Emperor, taking the baton from her dad, Shao Kahn, she committed quite a few atrocities and played a major role ultimately in Shinnok being revived. However, I don't know if Melina is inherently evil, even though you can say Shao Kahn and Shang Tsung pretty much molded her from evil. I just think she's largely misunderstood and she had a bad hand dealt to her just from the way she was born, man. So even though she came up doing fucked up shit, foul shit, she was raised that way, and it kind of leads me to have a little bit of sympathy for her. She's a murderous bitch. She's a man eater, but not necessarily evil enough to make this list. Our final honorable mention is Sindel. Now, when I first came across Sindel, I always thought she was just an evil bitch. Of course, it's before the story really got fleshed out and I understood what was really going on. But even after that, we get up to like Mortal Kombat 9 or whatever, Sindel, she's just evil. She's Shao Kahn's bitch, and she's fucking out here exterminating the fucking good guys. We all know she knocked off a considerable amount of fucking Earthrealm's heroes and made them into revenants, or they became revenants after she wiped their ass out. Some of the biggest and baddest, most beloved characters in Mortal Kombat history, Sindel is responsible for knocking them off the box, so I just always thought she was evil. Now, there's other people who look at this in a different light, understanding Sindel's history and how she became to be Shao Kahn's wife. In one version of the storyline, she was fucking abducted, more or less, when Shao Kahn came in and invaded Endymia. He pretty much made her his bride by force. She wasn't really down with the shit, so she took her life because she didn't want to be with this nigga. And, you know, they tried to play Sindel off as a hero, and that was like her sacrifice or whatever. So when she was revived to be evil and subservient and loyal to Shao Kahn, yada, yada, yada. But even if that was the case, I mean, she came back evil. And she seemed to relish in being an evil, wicked sorcerer bitch, being the queen, Shao Kahn's bitch or whatever. So I just always thought she was evil. And this is pretty much confirmed in Mortal Kombat Aftermath. Like, this bitch is just dirty. I won't spoil too much if you haven't played it, but the real Sindel stood up in Aftermath, so. Well, I won't necessarily say she's the most evil. She's this close to making my list of the dirtiest, most low-down motherfuckers in Mortal Kombat. I wouldn't trust this bitch as far as I can trust. Here we are at the meat and potatoes of our list with number 4, Shang Tsung. I struggle with where to put Shang on this list, or to even put him on this list and just slide him into the honorable mentions, which I'll get into a little bit later. But first of all, Shang, the reason why he needs to be on this list is because he's the first boss of the original Mortal Kombat game, evil sorcerer, doing all Shao Kahn's bidding. And not to mention, he's out here sucking the life out of niggas, literally. Stealing souls to fucking replenish his own powers and fucking pretty much live forever. If that's not evil, I don't know what the fuck is. Not to mention, he pretty much sabotaged the tournament to leave Earthrealm at a disadvantage. I'm sure he did this all throughout history. And that was probably how our world ended up winning 9 consecutive tournaments. So, Shang Tsung is pretty fucking shady, man. If you play through Aftermath or at least saw the storyline play out, you know that he belongs on this list because the nigga is just dirty as fuck. Now, the reason why I struggle with putting him on this list, because if you go into Shang's history, you will see that he's actually from Earthrealm. And back in the day, he was kind of like just a regular dude, you know what I'm saying? And he eventually became corrupted by Shao Kahn, who pretty much, from what I gather, Shang was like his apprentice. So he came up under Shao Kahn, who taught him all the ways of sorcery, trickery, fuckery, and all the shady shit that became such a big part of his character and who he is. But at the same time, I often got this fucking feeling that Shang Tsung is just, he's just Shao Kahn's fucking right-hand man. He's just doing his job and shit. Which he kind of said in the Mortal Kombat, I forgot the name of the series, but it was like a web series or something. It was like 10 episodes, and they had the guy who originally play Shang Tsung in the movie. He was trying to recruit Liu Kang to fight for Outworld, and he basically explained that I'm just doing my job, I'm trying to survive. I always kind of got that feeling about Shang, where he didn't necessarily feel as evil as some of the other motherfuckers out here kicking up dust. So, while I can't let him off the hook entirely, I don't think he's the most evil, rotten, filthiest, untrustworthy. Well, maybe he's the most untrustworthy, but there are people even more evil than OG Shang Tsung. Speaking of Shao Kahn, he is number 3 on our list. Shao Kahn, man, in my personal opinion, he is the boss of bosses. Not when it comes to Mortal Kombat, but when it comes to fighting games, period. I think he's the best boss of any fighting game. This don't necessarily have anything to do with his AI and how difficult he is to beat. I just think he's a badass. And I'm always throwing in some wrestling analogies or whatever, but I think he's kind of like Mortal Kombat's version of Triple H. Just the baddest bad guy, the fucking ultimate heel. And it's easy to see why, man. This dude is he's a conqueror, man. He just wants to come through and wreck your shit and take your bitch and make your shit his. Which is why he went around merging all these different realms, wiping through Adenia and all these nameless realms, and why he's so adamant on merging Earthrealm into Outworld, because he wants everything for himself. He's a power-hungry son of a bitch. And he's pretty damn evil, too. I mean, how can you not be evil when you out here just fucking wrecking shop and taking a nigga's bitch and claiming a nigga's kid as your own? And then when you get a feeling that she might act up, you have a clone created of her so you can control this bitch like in a different way. You can't control her in real life, so you're going to create a version of this bitch you can't control. It's some pretty twisted shit, man, but Shao Kahn, he plays by no rules but his own, man. As seen when he fucking broke the rules of the tournament and tried to invade Earthrealm, like, fuck the Elder Gods, I'm doing this shit anyway. Of course, we know that shit didn't necessarily work out for him, but the fact that he had the balls to do it is just like, wow, this nigga just don't give a fuck. Not to mention that he took out his own master in Onaga, where he was pretty much like playing Shang Tsung to him, poison him, and that's how he got the role as Outworld Emperor. And up until Liu Kang came around and all these other heroes who eventually beat him and destroyed him, Shao Kahn was wrecking shit for millennia. Just ongoing wrecking shop and making motherfuckers bow and kiss his motherfucking hammer. I think the fact that Shang Tsung has this deep burning hatred for him, it seems, also speaks to how evil and maniacal Shao Kahn is. I mean, when Shang Tsung couldn't get the job done, he basically took this nigga life force and put it into Sandel and gave her this huge power up, and that's how she went on the fucking killing spree and murdered all the heroes, man. So Shao Kahn, he don't give a fuck. He'll do whatever it takes and sacrifice whoever needs to be sacrificed for the greater good of the cause, which is always his cause. So he's definitely worthy of this number 3 spot and possibly higher on this list, but we sticking with number 3 for now. I never got a chance to play Mortal Kombat 4, so I wasn't quite sure what to make of Shinnok. And then you go around in a couple message boards, you see a lot of cats talking shit about him, like, you know, saying he was a Shang Tsung clone and pretty much writing him off as a joke, which may have something to do with how fucking corny video games were back in the day, dialogue and all. They didn't do him very much justice. But after doing some research on his character, and more importantly, seeing the storyline play out across Mortal Kombat 9 and Mortal Kombat X, I gained a tremendous respect for Shinnok and understand that he is one of the baddest motherfuckers in this whole franchise. Now, of course, I'm sure you all know the story of Shinnok. He's more or less like a Mortal Kombat version of Lucifer or the devil, whatever you want to say. He was an elder god who fell out with his fellow elder gods because he thought humans were pretty much shit. It's hard to argue with that, but he didn't feel they were worthy of being saved, so he got kicked out of elder god heaven, banished down to the nether realm, i.e. hell. Ended up fucking taking over the nether realm from Lucifer. I wish they found a way to incorporate that more visually into the story, because I would love to see how that all played out. But then we know from there, Shinnok goes on this long fucking, probably thousands of years going by, trying to fucking get out of fucking hell, the nether realm, and take over fucking Earth realm and pretty much just take over shit, period, man. And I love Shinnok's very regal, sophisticated, like, fucking aura he has about him. Like, he still carries himself like a god. He has this godly presence. He feels like everyone else is beneath him. And when you look at the power he's able to illustrate, it's hard to argue with that. I mean, aside from some elder gods, who the fuck is stronger than Shinnok? Okay, he got beat by the fucking cages. Yeah, whatever, whatever. I could say they got lucky, but Shinnok, he's a bad motherfucker. He was out here wrecking shit and had the fucking fate of Earthrealm looking pretty bleak for a minute. So I think just the basis of Shinnok, his origins, how they built the character over time, what he stands for, I think that makes him a very worthy holder of this number 2 spot for one of the evilest, most wicked, sadistic sons of bitches in Mortal Kombat history. Last but not least, it can be no other than Quan Chi. Quan Chi is another character that I didn't fucking learn about until recently because I didn't get a chance to play Mortal Kombat 4. And of course, the older games like Shinnok kind of make them look like a goofball and shit. But as time passed and I got to understand Quan Chi's story and his importance to the Mortal Kombat lore period, come to understand that he's pretty much got his hands tied into damn near everything in some very deceitful and fucked up ways. And the most fucked up of all, you gotta know, is the way he orchestrated the beef between Scorpion and Sub-Zero. Now, of course, their clans were already at each other's throats for hundreds of years, but because of Quan Chi framing Sub-Zero for the murder of Scorpion's family, that fucking faction rivalry became a fucking deep, venomous, nasty, fucking one-on-one rivalry that ended up with Scorpion losing his life, becoming Quan Chi's slave, Sub-Zero losing his life, essentially becoming Quan Chi's slave as new Saibot. Of course, Sub-Zero's brother, Kuai Liang, comes the fucking where the Sub-Zero mantle, where for a minute the rivalry still continued between Spectre Spectre Scorpion and the new Sub-Zero. But the fact that Quan Chi went through all this trouble to orchestrate all this shit, and you see just how dirty it is, man. If you've seen the Mortal Kombat movie Scorpion's Revenge, it's just fucked up, man. It was beautifully played, man, and why they played up the emotion and Scorpion's quest for revenge and just how hurt he was over this shit and killing this man's wife and kids. It's just, like, this nigga is just dirty as fuck, man, and the way he just taunted him about it, the little wisecracks he made about it, like, damn, this nigga ain't shit. And there was also some implications that led you to believe that he might have been involved in Sindel's suicide and corruption, but I think that was kind of cleared up in Mortal Kombat Aftermath. If you haven't played that, you can fucking check that out for yourself. But yeah, man, Quan Chi, just dirty as fuck, man. He teamed up with Shang Tsung briefly to overthrow Shao Kahn. They formed a little deadly alliance. But even that shit didn't work. Like, Shang Tsung, he knew that nigga was dirty. So they got the falling out, man. Even back in the day, even though I didn't play the game, I know that in Quan Chi's ending, he ended up betraying Shinnok. This is like his master. Everything he worked for is largely tied to reviving Shinnok so he can take over, rise from NetherRealm, take over EarthRealm and all the fucking realms, whatever, whatever. Even though that's an arcade ladder ending, not necessarily canon, you gotta have a feeling that Quan Chi, if he has his way, he's gonna portray Shinnok at the perfect opportunity whenever he can. Like, cause he's just that motherfucking dirty. In fact, he's the dirtiest, evilest, most untrustworthy son of a bitch in Mortal Kombat history. So there you have it, my list. It's a lot of evil characters in Mortal Kombat. Very gory game. Very violent. Deeply entrenched on the moral concept of good versus evil. So of course, there is quite a few savage, murderous motherfuckers running around damn near every realm, but I think these four take the cake as the baddest of the baddest, the wickedest of the wickedest, the most evil motherfuckers in Mortal Kombat history. But that's my list. Who's on your list? Let me know. Peace.